I can't stop eating. I don't know what's gotten into me. I think it's like kind of being home in the quarantine. I usually eat really healthy when I'm on tour, and you know how this is. I was on tour for 6 years, and all I was eating was like grilled chicken breast and rice and spinach, and sometimes like green room gummy bears. But since I've been home, I've had time to like experiment with different snacks, and I take it pretty seriously.
I love it. Well, maybe you can explain some of these snacks you've tweeted about. This one is dry Oreos are so weird to me, need dunkage, which I totally get. Like, I have to, I like a cookie soaked. I'm with you. I'm like, let's just soak it a little bit.
I can't eat them dry. I don't know. I don't understand people who eat Oreos dry. They also have to be double stuffed. That's a rule for me. And sometimes I like to smear peanut butter on them, which is an old trick I learned from watching The Parent Trap when I was a young child.
Yes. Oh my gosh, I love that movie. Also, I would really love your metabolism. like, wait, what? She's like double stuffed. I'm like, oh, okay. What's your latest snack obsession?
I started making Rice Krispie treats, but like without the Rice Krispies. And I know that doesn't make any sense, but I make them with other cereals. So like Fruity Pebble treats or like Cinnamon Toast Crunch treats. And they're so easy to make and they're so good.
Oh,
So
that's
good.
fun to do with your kids.
Yeah, definitely. Oh my gosh. If I was didn't like live alone and, with my dog and, have no or like family or like love in my home. I would have with my kids too.
You so
I'm just
much.
kidding. If any of my real friends are listening to that, it was a joke, I swear.
They're like, we need to call her right now. I hate that when I make jokes. People are like, you're fine right now. I'm like, I'm just being funny. All right, so you grew up in New Jersey. Is it true you guys had a bunch of urban legends?
Yeah, Jersey's a weird place. I think it's because everyone's so bored and we're not as cool as New York. So, like, you just kind of have to come up with things to make you special. So, one of the things that we came up with is like the Jersey Devil, who's like this, I guess, like creature that lives in the forest. There's like all
What?
these really weird, like, phenomenon that are really just a product of, I think, crazy people, but. There's like the profanity houses and Jenny Jump and just like a lot of urban legends that are mostly meant to scare kids into like not being out past curfew. But they definitely scared me when I was growing up. I fully bought into them. There's a whole book about it called Weird NJ that talks all about how weird New Jersey is with stuff like that. It's really weird.
I'm 38 and I'm not, I won't go near that stuff.